printed circuit boards. If you had a look at the inside of an electronic device made in the last 50 years or so, you almost certainly have seen a printed circuit board. Printed circuit boards are the engineering solution to the problem of interconnecting electronic components. Assume that you had an idea for a project. How do you get a PCB? Well, first of all, you have to design it, which nowadays means you'll use a CAD program on your computer. So you sit down with a cup of coffee and get started with the only puzzle game you can actually get paid for, PCB routing. Now, you either need to have the PCB custom made or make it yourself, which is the point of this video. But first, does it even make sense to make PCBs at home with all those online services which will produce professional looking PCBs for next to nothing? I say yes, for three reasons. First, because you can have your PCBs in less than a half a day, which won't be feasible for Chinese factories until someone invents teleportation. Second, because homemade PCBs can be almost as professional as factory-made ones. This PCB, for example, is actually homemade. Sure, you're limited to only single-sided PCBs until I, Honored Rage, come up with a way to make double-sided PCBs at home, but it's actually not that bad. Third, because it's fun, especially if you're into both chemistry and electronics. To make a PCB at home, you start with printing your design onto transparent film using a laser printer. You can tape a small piece of plastic film to a paper sheet for small PCBs. You may also need to scale your design a few percent to correct for printer scaling errors. Try to print pads for a fine pitch component and use the real component as a ruler to check for scaling issues. Then you cut some positive presensitized PCB board to the desired size. Presensitized means that those boards, other than being copper-plated, have a light-sensitive photoresist chemical that degrades where exposed to light, and a protective film that needs to be peeled off before use. You then put the mask on a glass plate, inside up, with a few drops of water to help with alignment. On top of that, you put the PCB, with the sensitive side down. An UV light box is needed to expose the PCB. The exposure time depends on the power of the UV light and sensitivity of the photoresist used in your PCB material, but is usually a few minutes. After exposure, it's time to prepare the developer solution, which for positive photoresist is 50 volumes water and 1 volume developer concentrate. If you're interested, I'll show in the next video how to make your own developer concentrate from sodium hydroxide and sodium metasilicate. With the proper developer concentration, the image should develop in around 1 minute. After the image is developed, rinse the PCB with water. At this point, the PCB copper should be exposed where it's not needed and covered by the photoresist where it's needed. To get our desired copper patterns, we just need to use an etchant to etch away the exposed copper. The copper chloride and hydrochloric acid etchant is what I use, as it can be regenerated by adding a few milliliters of hydrogen peroxide, and basically lasts forever, being thus also environmentally friendly. From time to time, check the PCB etching status, and in around 10 minutes the PCB should be fully etched. Once the PCB is fully etched, rinse it with water. The photoresist can be removed either by exposing the PCB again to UV light, this time without a mask, and using the developer solution a second time, or with a solvent such as acetone. To protect the copper from oxidation, to avoid solder bridges when soldering small components and to give the PCB a professional finish, solder mask can be added. Solder mask comes in sheets of gelled photoresist paint sandwiched between two plastic films like double-sided tape. To use it, you first remove the protective film from one side and apply it to the PCB. It takes some practice to get good results, as it's important not to leave air bubbles underneath. Once applied, it needs to be hot rolled for perfect adhesion using a modified document laminator. It is a good idea to do 4 passes from all sides and to wash the PCB with cold water afterwards. You need to print a second mask from your CAD files for the solder mask apertures. Note that the solder mask uses a negative photoresist, so what is exposed to the light is what remains. Exposure is usually faster than negative photoresist, a couple of minutes are enough, at least with my UV lamps. After that, you need to leave the PCB in the dark for 1 hour. The solder mask material, once exposed to light, needs to polymerize. To remove the solder mask where it's not needed, it has to be developed. Negative photoresist use a different developer than positive ones. For negative photoresist, sodium or potassium carbonate is used. A good formulation is 3 grams in 100 milliliters of water. Remove the second protective film from the photoresist and immerse it in the developer. Since the photoresist is gelled, it does not wash away by itself and needs to be gently scrubbed with a sponge. After another water wash, it is best to expose the PCB without a mask to the UV light for half an hour, to be sure the photoresist is fully polymerized. The PCB now has all the traces and the protective solder mask, but most PCB also need holes, so drilling is needed. Some of my friends like to play D&D, but I am into a more frustrating version of the game called CNC. How does it work? You buy a CNC machine, put your part in place, and roll a 20-faced die. If you can guess the number, your part will come out okay and you won't break any drill bits. CNCs are also perfect for drilling PCBs. Flatcam is used to convert the drill files produced by KiCad into G-code and BCNC to pass the G-code to the CNC itself. Here's the final result. This process allows to make traces as small as 0.15 mm, and the solder mask resolution is good enough to protect sensitive traces from short circuits during soldering. The last step is soldering all the components, and then the circuit is ready.